Wait, I thought it was going to give us another tape.
Didn't.
Oh, wait. Yes, it did.
Despite this statement,
I don't like this at all. Whoa, what happened? She can't possibly understand this. Like, you can't do this. Blow it up. Oh, no. Oh, yeah. That right there. Hey, everyone. It's your friend, Think Noodles, and welcome back to Amanda the Adventurer. We already had like an hour-long video on this and beating the game. If you missed that, go watch that first, then come back to this one, because we're not really going to cover the endings, I don't think, in this one. But what we are going to do is unlock the secret tape. So we'll actually just jump into the game here. This game is amazing. I mentioned it at the end of the last video, but from what this game came from till now is just incredible. The amount of content, the polish on this game is amazing. So each of these is an ending, right? This is the death ending we got first. This is the chopped up meat ending. This is the sad ending. And then this is the happy ending, or the good ending. There is one more ending, and I think we'll get it. Although it's not going to be very, I don't think it's very different. I saw a ton of your comments on how to get the secret tapes, and we got this orange one again in the previous video, sort of by chance. Basically cooked the wrong fruit because there was a clue in one of the videos. And well, we're going to continue with doing weird things, things that we normally wouldn't do to unlock the tapes. Now, there are 6 total slots here, and I know how to get 5 of them. Well, the other 4, and then the 6th one, the only people that have gotten it are people that, like, rip the movie files from games or YouTubers who got early access. And no one has said how you actually get it in the game. I think I saw one video where someone like no-clipped out of bounds to get this final tape. I don't know how it's possible. We'll try a couple things that I've seen comments about, but I don't know if any of them will work. If you know how, let me know how you get the dark blue tape that goes right here, because that is 100% of the game. We're going to get 99%. And actually, yeah, we'll go ahead with her. So if you remember, if we open up, I think it's this right here, and all of the codes stay the same. So we can just go back here and put in the guts and then open this baby up. And if you remember, we get the, I think they're in here, the scissors, right? Yeah, the scissors. But we're not gonna chop her head off this time. We're gonna throw those by the wayside, because you guys see that right there, that little flower? Well, if you remember, you can make different flowers from different colors. This is from different plants. So this is, I think, a lilac, right? Or no, this is pink. You don't want pink, right? So what we want is we want a duplicate flower of the little doll here. So let's look for, we want yellow. So it's like a 2 and a sort of like inserted in a 4. So let's look for that one. Nope. 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 Is it going to be like the last one I pick up? It is, isn't it? Wait. Hold on. Huh. Hey, are there any other ones? Oh, wait. Ah, see? See, and that's right there. That was there the whole time. That was just sitting there. But they put it in a inconspicuous spot. It doesn't look like anything. I mean, it looks like these, but you don't even look at it twice because it's a secret. So now we're going to go put it right here and wait for the flower to grow. Mm-hmm. Keep watering. And, oh, I can't, oh yeah, I can crouch. Let's see. Oh, keep going. Wait, is that it? Because it's not. Yo, this doesn't look the same. I think I got the wrong one here. Let's see if we can just put this on her like this. So I think it's the wrong flower, but.
Thank you.
Oh, no, it's the right flower. She says.
I yeah. got a surprise for you. Ooh. But you'll have to turn around.
She is
definitely going to take out a knife and stab me in the back.
Run! Oh, wait. Peekaboo. Okay. What? Hey, look. There it is. She just gave us a tape. Well, thank you. Thank you for not murdering me. Okay, so we've got, so we started with this orange tape. Now we got the light blue tape. Let's see what's in here. Now, some of these are pretty long. Oh, and also, so I almost feel like we should, before we go too far, let's recall what happened in that orange tape. Actually, wait, we don't have to, wait, can we eject? Because we could just watch it. Okay, we'll watch it after this. So let's just see if we can still piece it together. I remember it. You may not. Ooh. Oh, somebody's... Uh-oh. Somebody's going to jail. This looks like an interrogation room here. Oh, no. It's a scientist. Oh, there's a little girl. She's going to jail? What did she do? Okay. Wait, is there talking? No? Okay. So, this doesn't see... Okay. So, right here. This looks like a problem, okay? I don't know where this girl's parents are or guardian, but it looks like there's like a scientist, right? It looks like a lawyer trying to get this little girl to sign something. And this was... What is this? March 8th, 2002? That's not good. Wait, that date. Does that date have anything to do with anything? Do we have... Okay, so this is 1993. It's not dated. I'm just looking to see if there's anything... doesn't seem to be. I'm trying to remember when that news article was. Like the newspaper is when you get the clock thing. Just trying to get a timeline here. So he's passing this over to her. What are they saying? Is there supposed to be audio? So yeah, he's saying, look, sign this. Everything's fine. But I don't think that she can't possibly understand this. You definitely need, like, you can't do this. This is like, and it's on camera. This is illegal, the signature here, because a girl this age needs like an adult, someone over the age of 18 to sort of like verify the signature. That works with any legal document. That's it, really? And she was like a witness? That's not okay. Okay. All right, what's next? So now they're gonna bring the, oh. Oh, well, this is a security guy. Okay, now they're bringing her into a room. This doesn't look good at all. Okay, what's in there, dude? Okay. Oh, they're doing some. There's some lab testing going on with this kid. That. Okay. Well. That was pretty ominous. Okay, so that was 3-8-2002. Let's watch this back so we can remember what was in it. I mean, it was about a little girl and her birthday. Wait.
Birthday girl.
Hold on. Is that her? Is that the same girl? It could be the same girl. You can't tell. Obviously, she's wearing different clothes and her hair might be the right length. It looks a little short, but it looks like she's got a braid like down the side. She's watching Amanda the Adventurer. Oh, this hat, is that? It's not the same doll. I'm just trying to see if there's anything familiar from that other tape that we can link this girl to the one in the, you know, with the scientist.
Well, come okay. on, Lauren. We have
so
a special
she's
surprise
watching
for
Amanda
you.
The Adventurer. She won't break away from it at all. It's like they don't exist.
Ready for ice cream
her
cream?
Dad is she's Ted Lasso, of course. Friend. I mean, it's the perfect, like, he's got the sweater, the mustache, come on, like, even the hair. Okay.
Let me try, I wanna capture the
doesn't he, I mean, come on, right?
Lauren, honey, we got cake and ice cream, we got your favorite, mint chocolate chip.
Come on, baby, we can watch Amanda another time.
Okay, and then she's gone, right? Yeah.
Lauren?
Everything okay?
It's so much fun to buy your own. What is that episode about?
Lauren?
Yeah, okay, so now the parents are freaked out because she's gone.
Love
oh, wait, I didn't catch this before. Hold on. So the little kid, Lauren, her favorite flavor is mint chocolate chip. And then Amanda says that like right after. I mean, they think she went out the door. But does she like get zapped into the TV and now she's Amanda? Like she loves mint chocolate chip. It's almost like the dad's like, hey, we got cake and mint chocolate chip ice cream and the kid's gone. Cause you know, normally she'd run from mint chocolate chip ice cream, but she can't cause she's stuck in the TV, but they think she's out the door. Cause she says, I love mint chocolate chip as if she's responding to the dad. I totally missed that. Okay. And then, then that's the end. Oh, wow. I don't know how I missed that before. All right. So, I don't know, maybe? Oh, okay, so we actually have to watch the tapes. Because there is, as with all of these puzzles,
Hi, I'm
and like all the combinations. If you do it just a little bit different, like baking the pie differently. Like right here, see, you pause it on here, you turn on the oven, something else happens, right? That is with all of the puzzles, or using the peach instead of the apples. There is a different puzzle for the piano. And the funny thing is, like, all of these, like, different ways of solving the puzzle were there all, like, the entire time. Hiding in plain sight. That's what's really amazing about this game. All right, look. So it was March 24th, 2000. So the girl in the video signing the whatever she was signing, the contract, was 2 years after this. So I don't know what it has to do with Sam Colton or Amanda, but there it is. A little bit of a timeline, because, you know, we got to do all the clocks. Kind of makes sense, right? What if you just type yes? Oh! Oh! Oh. Whoops. I shouldn't have typed that. Oops. That's another ending. I mean, I think it's going to end up, yeah, bad. Yeah, we're going to die. But yeah, she asks if, like, if everything rots, and you're just like, yeah. And then, then the Amanda monster comes and kills you. All right, well, we're starting over. And that didn't get us another ending because it's just the same, but it actually kind of is. It's just a different point where that ending is.
Yoink.
Whoa. Oh, you can pick his head up. Dude, why? Why can... Oh my goodness, what if... Wait a second. we'll get to the key in a second. I was just trying to like loop it back because I feel like I've missed something. But what if I cut her head off and put Blabbot's head there? Is that possible? Let's see. Okay, slice. Sorry about that. Now, let's pick it up. Can we put it back? Oh, no, you can't. Oh, I'm sorry. I cut off your head unnecessarily. All right, let's loop it back. Oh, you know, there's one more like sort of like route that I haven't like quite... taken yet, the meat pie route, because I'm looking for something like more changes in the videos. All right, and you guys were asking like what happens if you don't throw the brick, so I'm kind of trying to do that as well. So this is all cutscene here. I'm not doing anything. Okay, it picks up the brick, and now I have control, but I can't like move or like do anything except just change my view, and I can't, let's just wait. We'll wait and see if anything happens. I mean, everything's corrupted in there, but it seems like it's on a loop. You can also see like someone's trying to get out of there. Like in addition to the cartoon, it looks like someone's trying to get out of the TV. But yeah, it just loops. Yeah, you gotta smash it. There's nothing else you can do. And then, yay, becomes daytime. Hooray. And then end credits. Yeah, here we go. Yeah.
Burn it down, baby.
Let's go now. Yeah. So this will change things a little bit. Well, actually, why did it? Come on. There. Now we get to watch the rat close up. I didn't get to see it last time. Or can you not? Oh, it doesn't. I was trying to catch it, but it just, just as you turn away, you don't get to see it. Well, get slaughtered. I guess that's really not a bad thing, honestly. Wait, give me, oh my, I didn't set it yet. I gotta preheat it. Ugh, rats and stuff all over the floor. Pick it up, put the rat in the pot, please. Pan. Oh, nope, that. Ah! Okay, now. Yeah, so it gives us a new version of the In Your Neighborhood tape. So there might be something different in this. Right, yeah, because it added the candy store and all that. Yeah, right?
Is that... I don't need to go there right now.
We're going here, sorry.
Good job.
Oh, there it is. There. So that is something that's different right there. The notes. So with the music box puzzle, oh, but it's not on the table. So you kind of have to be able to read music here. And thankfully, like when I was in like middle school, I played saxophone. So I can read a treble clef, That is C. The little line is B, then A, then G, then F, and then goes up to another octave. So we got F, A, C, A, D, E. F, A, C, A. Oh, that actually spells facade. So that's both like a musical puzzle. F, A, C, A, D, E. Ha ha ha! Beethoven, that's me, dude. Kinda. I can read basic quarter notes. Okay. Oh wait, we gotta finish this, huh? Okay. You stay there, red tape. Wait, don't lose the red tape. All right, let's finish this off. All right. So that's done. Let's try this tape. So we've got light blue. Well, orange. I feel like I'm playing Poppy Playtime here. All right, so we've got red tape now.
Mm-hmm. It's been 3 weeks since local television producer Sam Colton was reported missing, and authorities still have no leads.
Oh, he's missing!
Colton is the creator of Amanda the Adventurer, the public access children's educational program that became a huge hit among area children.
Right.
But with Colton's disappearance, the future of the show remains unclear. Last year, Hamlin Entertainment purchased rights to the live-action program starring Colton's daughter, Rebecca.
Whoa, oh!
As budget and production...
Hold up! That's the girl that was signing, I think. We'll go back, but that looks like her hair in this one. So the girl that we saw, Lauren, it's not. This is his daughter. And this, I'm almost sure this is the person signing that thing with the lawyer. Maybe it has something to do with his disappearance. Maybe this, we might see a date, but this news program might have something to do, like might be predating.
Value increased, Hamlin reimagined the show as an animated series, planning to syndicate the program nationally.
Okay.
Hamlin's acquisition of the program and Colton's recent disappearance have raised some eyebrows. And to further fuel these concerns, new episodes of Amanda the Adventurer have had subject matter that has left local parents uncomfortable about the program.
So they're producing it.
My kids are still really into that show, but it has changed. I mean, I walked in the other day and Amanda was talking about how mommies and daddies aren't always right. That's not something you tell impressionable kids.
I mean, sometimes
I had to change the channel. I just told the kids that the TV was acting up.
Dude, you know, sometimes parents are.
It's not yet clear
how
Colton's disappearance will affect the involvement of his daughter, Rebecca, the show's young star. We reached out to Hamlin Entertainment.
So she's the voice, right?
While representatives declined to comment, they did release a written statement.
Okay.
We at Hamlin have concerns surrounding the nature of Sam Colton's abandonment of both our program and his daughter.
He went missing. What do you mean abandonment?
On his reasons for leaving. We do ask that the community respect the privacy of Rebecca Colton, as she needs time out of the spotlight to process these disturbing events.
This is like a corporation.
For the time being, Rebecca's local appearances have been canceled, including the Kensdale Public Library fundraiser, Woolies Readathon, this Saturday evening. Rest assured that Amanda is not going anywhere. Hamlin Entertainment remains committed to our vision for this cherished program. Despite this statement, authorities have not drawn any conclusions about the nature of Sam Colton's disappearance.
I'm drawing some.
We will share any future updates as the story develops.
Mm-hmm.
When we return, we'll check in with Zappo, the talking gerbil.
What? Okay, so I don't like that at all because Amanda...
Your friend, Skip, and with me as always is my trusty dog, Chip.
Chip and Skip! This is like Dread XP. Oh, I thought it was going to keep going. That's like one of their first games. Oh, man. Okay, that's cool. All right, well, let's put this here. So I don't like, oh my goodness. I think it'll go up there when we like watch the next tape or something. Okay, that was weird physics. So they said he abandoned his daughter and then in the next breath, they're like, yeah, but we're taking care of her. And also she signed that document, which probably when her dad went missing, they took her in her room, had her sign like her life away to this corporation so she can continue to make episodes of this show so they can make money and, keeping her from public appearances so she doesn't say, God, help me there. They've chained me to a microphone. Wait, I feel like I'm chained to a microphone sometimes, but chain me to a microphone so I can voice this character and are mistreating me. I don't like it. She doesn't have a parent to protect her anymore. All right, so the What's a Family video. Now, I got this out of my comments, and it makes sense now that we've watched a few of these, because I was like, what are they talking about? So we're going to go see the chickens.
Great.
Yeah, so we go see the silly chickens.
Silly chicken.
And then she asks us, what a cute family, right?
Having a family is nice.
Having a family is nice.
I see a mommy chicken
and baby chickens.
And I see...
A daddy chicken. Right.
Look at the chicken.
Uh-huh.
Do you know what the daddy is called?
So right here, according to my comments, we're supposed to put in Rebecca's dad's name. Since she's the voice of Amanda, we're supposed to put in Sam. Now this is...
Wait, what did you say?
Yes. We got the achievement.
Where should we go next?
Oh, but it...
I think it's time to visit the sheep. Can what? You tell me where we can find the sheep?
Wait, I thought it was going to give us another tape. So, they said it would give me another tape. Okay, well, we'll continue through it. Maybe, is it? Oh, it didn't. Oh, wait, yes, it did. Okay, we got to grow. Okay, let's finish this tape. Okay, all right. So, yeah, I mean, that makes sense. We say it, and then it gives us this other tape. Even though, like, and that's the thing, right? Like, right here... I don't know what I'm supposed to answer here. Uh-oh. There's nobody to love her. I will alone. Oh, yeah, right. Alone. Right. Okay. Yeah, and this all makes sense. There's no one to help her. Like, she's the kitten, right? Yes. Of course. Yeah. Okay. There you go. Give me. Okay. So, yeah. That's what's so good about this game. There's, like, you know, even though, like, it looked like you were supposed to type, like, rooster... If you type the short part, she's like, wait, that's my dad. Okay, next one. Now, I hope this one has sound, too, because that one... Oh, this one's blank? Come on! Oh, wait. Ooh. Coffee Break with Sadie Copen. That's a name we don't...
Welcome to Coffee Break.
Hi.
Today, I'm talking with Sadie.
Oh, this is before we went missing.
The creator of the hit kids show, Amanda the Adventurer.
Mm.
And I have to say, a fantastic studio neighbor.
Thanks for having me on the show, Sadie. You're a pretty good studio neighbor yourself.
Oh, that's nice.
Though, I'm going to gain 50 pounds if you keep stocking the kitchen with those delicious homemade cookies.
Wow. I like her.
Without cookies.
Yeah, seriously.
Sam,
yeah.
Last year you started producing Amanda the Adventurer right here in the studio.
Mm-hmm.
The whole town loves it.
Yeah.
Did you even imagine that would be such a big sensation?
Honestly,
of course
Sadie,
not. Everyone's going to say no.
It was a total surprise.
Yeah.
I mean, it's scrappy at best. You know how it is when you have a big idea and a little budget.
Okay, there's no tea in there.
Kids don't really care about that, though.
Right.
They see the heart.
Mm-hmm.
And boy, does your show have a big heart.
Is there like...
You know, I really have to thank our local librarian, Miss Kate, for being such a champion of the...
Okay, right there. That's a reference to our aunt, Kate, right here. Catherine Park, dedication to Children's Library Services. So that's how we're related to this, is because she promoted the show.
Project. I think she's talked about it at every single story time.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's just so rare nowadays for kids' shows to be so much fun, but also really teach kids something, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
What inspired you to create Amanda?
His daughter?
Mm-hmm. I wanted to create a show that teaches children that our world is a magical place. That there are little adventures waiting around every corner in their very own neighborhood.
Like Talking Lambs?
The show is a celebration of kids' imaginations.
All right.
But really, it's all Rebecca.
Daughter, yep.
As soon as I met my beautiful daughter, the inspiration was there. You know, she was so young when I adopted her.
Oh, he adopted her.
She's gone through. She's always seen the world with such kindness and joy. She's the light of my life, and it makes me so happy to share that light with our community.
She really is something special. Watching her perform is simply delightful. I mean, the whole show is just so cute.
Thank you, Sadie.
Do you see big things happening with Amanda the Adventurer?
I've actually had some people approach me about
He's talking about Hamlet. Hamlin
into a cartoon. I can't really talk about it yet, but it's exciting. It feels like a dream, the idea of welcoming even more kids into this wild, creative world. It feels like my little show could really have a big impact.
Oh, wait. So was the show originally not a cartoon?
Having a coffee break with me today. With her? Our community is so lucky to have you. And Rebecca. On our next coffee break, floral arrangements for all occasions. All right. Featuring the newest addition to our neighborhood, Rose Matthews of Rose's Bouquet. Until then, may your coffee always be steaming and the conversation sparkling. Are you both good? And you're so good.
What a set. It's still going. There might be something here. Come on. Get ready.
Nope.
All right. Okay, so this is 4 of 5. And I still can't put it there. You just can't. Okay, there. It's there. Nope. It's not. All right, I think this is the one, the accidents one. Because this is where she like, yeah. Okay, yeah, this is where she attacks Wooly. This is the one we need. Okay.
Don't...
Yep. Right. Okay, cool. I mean, sorry, Wooly, but it is.
Wooly.
So it hurt his knee.
That's right.
Yep.
Wooly hurt his knee. Who can help when you are hurting?
Okay, so this right here is where you enter something different, and it's, I think...
You're probably
there it is, the
right.
Sad truth. Nobody can help you
Let's
when you're hurting.
Wooly to the hospital to see a doctor.
Yeah. So that...
Which room should
I think actually unlocks the tape. Yep, purple tape right there. Okay, so we've got to watch the end of this. I also wanted to enter a couple of other ones just to see if it changes it. Let's just try these just to see if like it makes any difference, because there were a couple. And I'll show you I'll show you the comment on screen on why I'm choosing this. So there is something that changes in the credits from like, I think singers or something. This person's comment here unveils it, but so they said to use MARCUS.
I don't think they can help.
Okay, and then the other thing I was thinking is Hamelin.
Don't you want to help Wooly?
I mean, I don't know. I was thinking maybe. Oh. Wait, I put in Amanda. What? Why did it?
Why are you even here?
Whoa!
Again? You're almost there. I'm wasting my time.
I don't remember getting that angry. Yeah, that makes you do doctor.
All right.
I don't think that probably did us anything. Yeah, this blue, the dark. So there's a dark blue tape that goes there. And again, I don't know how to get it. So this is gonna be the final tape that we can unlock. The final secret tape. Let's see what's on it. Okay. What is that? Is that emergency? Oh no, what does that say? Oh, recording. Recording, that's quiet.
Great. Let's move on to the next one.
Bio. Bio.
Bye.
Bio. Pie-man. 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 Bala.
Those are like...
What is this?
These are demons.
What is he reading?
I think it's
a few simple words. This script is specifically tuned to train the technology's dynamic voice reaction.
Oh, they're training an AI.
I want this to
So stop. He's still here. Training an AI.
Sam, why don't you take a walk for a few minutes? We've only got a few more of these.
No, I don't want to do that.
Rebecca, what's wrong? Who are you talking to?
The man in the headphones.
Oh, okay. This is direct.
Man, she's upset. This is going too far. Let's just take 5. Rebecca, come on out, and we'll...
Whoa, what happened? Oh! Okay, so there's that. Oh, and there's one more ending! Okay, that's not it. I was gonna say that's it. No, if we continue... Hold on. We've gotta continue here. So while I complete this, what that looks like to me is they were Hamelin had beaten or had signed the contract, bought the show from Rebecca's dad, Sam, and they were recording lines to train like an AI to speak lines for her, sort of like taking the soul out of his creation, out of the show, which is his daughter, the whole inspiration of the show. And it looked like she was going a little crazy, like reciting. I mean, I don't know. It seemed like those are the names, well, at least like in some horror games that I remember, those are like names of demons that she's reciting, although they're making it sound like they're saying like nice things like Bebaw and stuff. But she ain't liking it. She's starting to hear things and her dad's like, that's enough. And that makes me think that what they, you know, the dad kind of pulled her out of it. And Hamlin's like, we paid a ton of money for this show. We want the actress. We need her. And they made the dad disappear. Oh, right. Yeah, this is all we have to do, actually. We just have to do, what was it? 2862, I think. Yep. Okay. And we just need the water. Yep. Water bucket. Get the key from the blab bot. Then we splash him. And now that we've gotten 5 out of 6 tapes, it should trigger a new ending slightly. Yeah, because we just need, we can share. Right. This will pull an ending. So
are
you just got to
sure?
Tell her yes. Yes.
Is it really okay?
And then she said, it's
I'm
so haunting.
Out there.
I'm out there.
Somewhere.
So haunting. Then this happens, of course. We saw this a few minutes ago. Now we throw this at the TV. Bam, we blow it up. And then there's a slight difference. The sun comes up, but I think we, oh no. Oh yeah, that right there. There's a man at that table and it says the end ? And there's a man with like a detective hat on. And this is what I was talking about. If you look further through the credits. Yeah, look right here. This is that part with the happy birthday singer and it's like an hex code and you shift it with a cipher and all that stuff for Marcus. I don't know. Didn't work out. But I think once we get to the title screen, by getting all of... Yep, there it is, right there. That is the hat that the dude was wearing. I don't know what it signifies or whose it is. I did see a hat in... Well, actually, I'll show you. I don't know if it's the same hat, but let's look real quick here. I noticed it where the girl was, where Lauren was.
Where's
watching
the birthday
TV.
Girl?
Right. Okay. So I don't know if it's the same hat. It's pink. So probably not, but whatever. I noticed a similarity. Okay. And it's not how I remember it at all. Now, again, there is a 6th tape. However, if you look on my achievements right here on Steam, I've unlocked all achievements, 19 out of 19, 100%. I 100%ed the game, yet I'm still missing a tape. Now, as I said before, the only people I've seen unlock the tape where you can watch it are people who go out of bounds and grab it, or people who got pre-release copies of the game, which may have gotten it unlocked for them. But let's watch one real quick, just so we can see it's actually kind of a bland tape. All right, I'm checking Manly's channel just because, I trust that he probably got them all because I know he got a pre-release copy. Oh yeah, here we go.
Detective hat ending.
All right, here we go. There. This is the tape I can't get. Let's see what's on it. And I think it's supposedly pretty bland. Okay,
herd of mouth
with Wooly the sheep.
I feel like that's reference to maybe they said they had. Wooly was gonna have like a read along or something weird that got canceled.
Yeah, I feel like
Wooly.
Yep, there he is.
How do you do?
So like this is like any other show or like a podcast or something where there's usually guests and you know there's someone to play off of each other and it looks like poor Wooly is just boring. He's boring by himself without Amanda, without the soul of the show. As I was saying before, that company is trying to have Amanda in the show or Rebecca in the show permanently with AI because she's the life of the show. With just Wooly, this is what the show is like without Amanda. This is what it would be like. This is what they're worried about because they paid a lot of money for it. And oh my goodness, he just scratched his butt. I'm just going through it because he is not like talking or
he's
or anything, dude. He's not. He's got nothing, like nothing to talk about, nothing to say without Amanda.
He's looking around.
Oh, okay. He still just doesn't know what to say. I mean, there's nothing on the table. What would he talk about? Oh, wait, what did he, did he just whisper something? Hold on. What did he do there? Oh, he coughed.
Coughing again.
Oh, what? He got an idea. Or not. Dude, oh, that's it. Okay, so didn't miss a lot in that. And it doesn't look like it unlocked anything else on the TV. It still has the same endings. And again, I got 100% all the achievements on Steam. And you really had to unlock the 5 of 6 tapes to get this final ending, which was just like a tiny little bit. But it unlocked that sticker and the end question mark as an achievement. That's about it for your Amanda the Adventurer. Although one more thing, this is what I was talking about. No, this isn't adding more secrets yet. So maybe in future updates of the game, we are going to see secrets added. If you guys want me to keep an eye on this game, keep an eye on the progress, and if they add any content to the game, play it again, click the like button, subscribe, and I'll see you guys again soon. Thanks for watching. And of course, noodle on.